weeks in our final month. We're underway in week 14. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The first carry for Kenyon Drake, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Now check on numbers for Kenyon Drake last week. He was, without a doubt, one of the catalysts in that victory.
And he could really be the glue that makes this offense go, because when defenders have to commit to stopping him, that just opens up more.
And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They go play action now. Cutler. And incomplete on the deep ball. Devontae Parker was the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
Here we go now. Boom,
out of the gun, it's Cutler. And he's got his man, that's Landry. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. He got 29 yards that time.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
He was trying to hit Thomas that time, and that'll bring up second down. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And he will score. Touchdown, Miami. Jay Cutler, his first touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins take it right down and score on the opening drive. And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who were blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves sticking in the end zone on a running play.
And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. All-pro tight end Rob Gronkowski. So those are the numbers for Gronk in last week's outing. I asked him before the game, did you know that you were close to 200 last week? He said short of it, but a touchdown as well. Heck of a game.
I like that he was honest with you because they always know. They keep track in their head. They understand their yardage. But how'd you like to be the defense this week? This was a week of open field tackling practice because you know he's going to get his catches. The key is to limit him after the catch, put him on the ground.
These guys hooking up right away here, Charles. Two plays, both passes in his direction, and both catches.
And in our time together, have we not seen the tight end position continue to develop in the passing game? You know, at some point, we may not call them tight ends anymore. We may have to come up with an entirely different way of designating that position and what they do on the field. Because when I hear tight end, I think of the old school, hand in the dirt, blocking on the line of scrimmage. These guys are much more receiver than they are guys who are going to move in the pass in the running game.
And let's give you a look here at the New England offense.
Well, we all know that Rob Gronkowski is one of the premier tight ends in the NFL, but what makes him that way is the size. We see that. The ability to run, he's faster than a lot of wide receivers. The agility, he's almost like a power forward in basketball, and the competitiveness. When that ball is released, he decides it's his and no one else's.
Gronkowski, the intended target, and it's third down. They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got him complete. But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter.
When I see Cameron Wake make plays like that, I can't help but shake my head sometimes. He had to go to Canada first before he came back to the NFL. He's now an all-pro.
Yeah, undrafted out of Penn State, but look at him now.
And just think about all the pass-rushing moves he has, his ability to play against the run. Remember, he was a combo outside linebacker defensive end.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. This is Hill, and they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rush will just tee off on your quarterback and makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
And he will not only not get the yard he needed, he goes the wrong direction. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make it third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
No movement from the field goal unit. They've got 4 full yards to go here on fourth and goal to hit pay dirt, but they're going to go for it. It's Brady. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Kiko Alonso. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Now, after the interception, here's Cutler. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Thomas. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out. And by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Now a play fake here on first down. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
We know about his arm strength. We're all impressed. We can't help but be when he fires one. But that overthrow there, that's the thing we think that may be preventing him from being in the upper echelon of quarterbacks in the NFL.
Just the overall accuracy.
Yeah, I think that's a big part of it. Overall accuracy and really lack of success in the playoffs. So for Jay Cutler.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Jonathan Newsom coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
And I know it seems like we say this a lot in broadcast booths, but a quarterback can hold on to the football too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football, save some yardage to make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hipped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
Holding offense.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Let's go. Three.
Now Cutler on third and long. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the 2.
Now this is where field awareness comes into play. He's getting perilously close to his own goal line, and after that sack, backed up to his own 2.
Here's Jeff Locke now, and no room for error here as his first punt. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. That's taken on the 25. Give him 11 yards that time on the return, and the Patriots take over. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception, but they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
From midfield, here's Brady. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. And it's second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They come after him, they sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
The Patriots pick up the first down, Brady to Amendola. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Miami after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studio. Most intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
But nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking.
That throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete.
And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And it's going to be third down and a ways to go here, 3rd and 14. From the gun, it's Brady. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on 4th. Now Brady. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
Ah, yes, Brady to Gronk. You think these two are in sync?
Without a doubt. And look, they both understand what they can do for each other. Gronk knows if he gets open, the ball's going to be there. And Tom Brady knows what a great security blanket Gronk is. When all else fails, you find Big 87.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. Brady will try again on second down. And right side caught Hogan. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Chris Hogan, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half.
Well,
there's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Here's Jarvis Landry now on the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Dolphins offense now ready to go back out onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. And never mind, Larry. These two teams apparently anxious to get back at it. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Here comes Philip Dorsett now to return it. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. They give them a gain of 38.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody has that ability, they want them on their team.
Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski, and that'll bring up second down. Well, pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Goes right side, complete to Gronk. And he's going to get into the end zone. So cue up the Gronk spike, gets a Patriot touchdown. Rob Gronkowski, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots have taken the lead. The drive there only spanning three plays. And it ends with a New England touchdown. Gronkowski now out to kick it away. And this this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Off the play fake. Here's Kettler. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. On third and short, Drake. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. Here's Jeff Locke now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And now a high kick trying to pin him back. That'll go for only 17 yards on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And here comes Rob Gronkowski and company. And the previous drive put him up over 1,000 yards for the season. So now it's what you like to refer to, my friend, as gravy time, right?
It is. I mean, he's done it, right? He's accomplished the goal. So the good players, they relax a little. They bask in it. They think this up. Okay, we've done what we set out to do. The great players decide to push that number as high as they possibly can. I don't expect him to have any let up in his game the rest of the way.
Great thing if you're on the opposite side. He's such a weapon. He just opens things up for the other guys around him.
Yeah, if you're the opposite receiver, you should expect a few passes to come your way too, because I've got to kick coverage in his direction.
They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Gronkowski, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. Big reason why they have the lead, but now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot, but they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall. You know, some teams use the running game just to bludgeon people. I think that Brady to Gronk does the exact same thing for them. Long, short, medium, they know how to connect.
In ways, it's sort of revolutionized the quarterback-tight end relationship. They can go, as you told me before, they go medium, they can go short, they go long.
And the way that Gronk is used, he's not just a tight end. Oftentimes, they'll put him on the backside of formation as a single wide receiver, and he runs routes exactly that way.
They'll run it with Hill. And he keeps fighting his way into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Jeremy Hill with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. A good sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice 2-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field and down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time. They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage. But
weaving through traffic, and now he's free. Touchdown. Kenyon Drake, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Dolphins have got it back to a one-score game. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Here comes Tom Brady and the Patriot offense back onto the field. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the third.
And that's the word that they're always seeking from the guy taking the snaps, is consistency.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Lawrence Timmons. Coming hard on the blitz, he dumps him for a loss of 8. That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number 1. And, you know, they had 5 last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback, but you show them a lot of different looks, and they did that in the first half. You know, different angles, different things to slow down the speed. Come up with a counter to that and maybe do something different. There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Second down now after the pass completion. On play action, now Brady. To the sideline and complete to Gronkowski. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Only 3 yards.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th-and-1. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
It's a gain of 4 that time, and it'll give the Patriots a first down. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
He was looking for Gronk that time, and now it's 2nd down. A little too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by the rookie from Clemson, Cordray Tankersley. And he will bring it back. It's a pick 6 and a Dolphins touchdown.
Bill Partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using 5 defensive backs, 6 defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Patriot offense heading back out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. A great Monday night to wrap up the week in football. Two division rivals and a great finish ahead as we come up on first and 10. This is complete to guess who? Gronkowski again. 23 yards on the play. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
Looking middle, it's caught by Gronkowski. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Now, that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. On second down, here's Brady. Complete. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellent.
And this is going to be intercepted.